Last December, I set a goal to publish a new video on my YouTube channel every week in 2024, and here we are with the 52nd and final video of the year. On top of that, this channel just broke 40,000 subscribers the other day, which is still mind-boggling when I think about it. And I just want to say thank you so much to everyone who's been a part of this journey with me. It's an absolute honor to be able to serve you in this way as you make your own strides to improve your photography. Of course, if you're watching this video because YouTube thinks you'd enjoy it and you're not yet a subscriber to the channel, then I'd love it if you would become a subscriber because next year will be filled with even more photography and Lightroom education. So don't miss out on that. All right, now on to this final video for 2024. Earlier this month, Adobe released an update to Lightroom Desktop with an improvement that I was waiting years for, which is enhanced Photoshop interoperability. You can check out that video in this card above to learn all about that update. Now, in the wake of that video, I got a number of questions about how to make the most out of a hybrid Lightroom and Photoshop workflow. So that's what this video will be all about. While sending photos from Lightroom to Photoshop and back is pretty straightforward, there are a few things that you'll want to keep in mind just to make that experience even better. So let's dive in. All right, so again, the purpose of this video is to be able to kind of answer questions before you think about having to ask them. And it has to do specifically with working with Lightroom Desktop and Photoshop. And so this is obviously Lightroom Desktop on my Mac, but this is essentially the same if you're a Windows user. And so obviously the basic thing is to send a photo to Photoshop from Lightroom, you can either right click and go to edit in Photoshop. And we now have these three options. This again is covered in my update video when Lightroom was updated in December or early December, 2024. You can also go to file over here, go to edit in Photoshop and there you go. So that's like the super basic. Now, it also goes without saying that you are a subscriber to the photography plan, which gives you access to Lightroom and Photoshop. You obviously need Photoshop in order to use this workflow. So if you are subscribed to the Lightroom only plan, then you'll have to change to the photography plan, or you could subscribe to Photoshop by itself, but you need both of those apps. All right, so the most common question that I've gotten, without a doubt, has to do with, you know, let's say you're in grid over here and you right click and I'm going to edit this in Photoshop and I'm just going to send it to Photoshop on its own layer. So here's one of the first questions. You can see here that Photoshop beta was launched. If you have Photoshop beta installed, it will be the default version of Photoshop that launches when you send a photo. Now, if you go to the Creative Cloud desktop app over here, and then you click on the apps button, you should have this beta tab up here. If you click on it, Photoshop beta should be available. As far as I know, this is available to anyone who is subscribed to the photography plan or who has Photoshop. So if you want the beta installed, you can do that. You would just have this kind of install button and there you go. You can also, of course, if you go to all apps, have the production version of Photoshop installed as well. You can have both of them installed at the same time. In fact, you can see in my dock here, there's Photoshop beta. It's kind of got that checkerboard pattern indicating that it's a beta. And then there's the production version, which is the general icon that you would see here with the blue, the dark blue background there. So if you have Photoshop beta installed, Lightroom will open in Photoshop beta by default. Now, let's say you don't want it in Photoshop beta. Let's say you want to have Photoshop beta installed, but you want your photo to be open in the production version of Photoshop. So I'm going to go ahead and quit this over here. We're back in Lightroom. If you want that, then what you'll want to do is first launch Photoshop. So you can see here, I'm just going to launch it. And it looks similar to the beta version, but you can see up here, it just says Photoshop 2025. Now, if I do the exact same thing, if I right click and go to edit in Photoshop over here, you'll see that it will open in Photoshop, the production version of Photoshop. There you go. And it won't open in beta. So it's just one of those things. I've had people ask me that, like, why is it opening up in beta? That's just kind of how Lightroom is doing it right now, is it sends it to the, I guess, the newest version. You can see here, actually, if we go to about Photoshop, this is 26.2 over here. And then if I quit out of here, and let's send it one more time, which will open in beta. Again, you can see up here it says beta. And if we go to About Photoshop, it's 26.3. All right, so now you know how to force the photo to go into the production version of Photoshop if you have both that version and the beta version installed. Now let me walk you through what is also possibly the most common question I've gotten, and that is, why isn't my photo coming back to Lightroom after I've saved it from Photoshop? So I'm gonna just send this to the production version of Photoshop over here. So again, that means that we're going to launch it first, and then we're just going to send it over to Photoshop. All right, so here you can see there is the image open in Photoshop, and I'm just going to, I'm just gonna apply a curves adjustment really quickly, just to make an edit here so we can see that something changed. And so you can think, all right, well, I'm just gonna go and select File, click Save, and you can see it saved here. And then when you go to Photoshop, you're like, where's my photo? I don't see my photo, where is it? I've been waiting 15 years and the photo is still not here. Well, that's because saving is not the actual process that will get the image to import back into Lightroom. Saving is important, it's required, but the thing that will cause the image to re-import into Lightroom is closing. So you can close several ways. You can press Command or Control W. You can click on the little X icon here on your document tab. You can go to File and select Close. I'm gonna do that. Now, as soon as I did that, you can see Lightroom gained focus. You can see up here, import from Photoshop. The image will import into Lightroom and it will stack if you are using cloud. And that's actually another important thing because stacking is only supported in cloud. If you're using local, the image will just appear alongside your original. So here, if you don't want the stack, all you need to do is right click and go down here to ungroup stack. And you'll have both images side by side. Of course, because I am working in the cloud, you can see that the image is automatically syncing to the cloud over here. Now let's go ahead. I'm gonna actually delete this because there's another thing that I wanna illustrate in terms of what happens when you send a photo from Lightroom to Photoshop. All right, so you can see I still have Photoshop launched over here. This is the production version. So once again, I'm going to right click. I'm gonna go to Edit in Photoshop and then send to Photoshop. Now, this doesn't matter whether you're just sending it to Photoshop or you're sending as a smart object. I'm just sending it to Photoshop as is. The first thing I want you to understand is that when Lightroom sends a photo to Photoshop, it's sending a 16-bit TIFF file. You can see up here, it's a TIFF file. So even though we started with a Sony RAW file, the file that Lightroom automatically creates is a TIFF file. It's also a 16-bit TIFF file using the Profoto RGB color space. So these are just a few things I wanted to bring up just so that you were aware. And the reason for that is because it operates a little bit differently if you're using Lightroom Mobile on your iPad, for example, with Photoshop on the iPad. You have the ability to send an image just like we did from Lightroom on the iPad to Photoshop, except there it's going to send it as a PSD file, whereas on the desktop, it'll send as a TIFF. Even if you work with layers, those layers are still supported. TIFF supports layers, so you don't have to worry about that. But it's just something I have gotten those questions, especially from hybrid Lightroom users who use desktop and mobile, and they're just confused, like, why am I seeing TIFFs on the desktop and PSDs on mobile? That's just the way it is. You didn't do anything wrong. It's just how it was designed. Now, it is possible in some cases for example, Photoshop to crash or Lightroom to crash. And in those situations, you might have an orphaned file. So this file that was created here is actually sitting in a temporary folder until the image is either discarded, meaning you quit without saving, or you save and then close, in which case it would import into Lightroom. Until you do either of those things though, your image is kind of sitting in this temporary folder. And this is important because these TIFF files can get pretty big in file size. And so it's always good to every now and then just monitor this location just to see if you have any orphaned TIFF files. So let me show you how to get to that folder on Mac and Windows. So let's start with the Mac here. The easiest way to get to it on Mac is by opening up a Spotlight search here, and I'm gonna start typing terminal. And then what you're gonna do is you're going to type in this command, open space dollar sign tmpdir, so temporary directory. That's all you have to do here. When you do that, you'll see this finder window up here. And I recommend going into this view here where you have the column view and then sorting by date modified and making sure that the newest stuff is on top. And there you can see there is MAT08379.TIFF. If we go back to Photoshop, you'll see MAT08379.TIFF. And you can see it's a pretty big file, 321.6 megabytes. Now, if Photoshop, for example, crashed for whatever reason, or Lightroom crashed and it kind of broke that round tripping, then this file could be orphaned in this temporary directory, and why it's important for you to kind of every now and then just look for these TIFF files. Now on Windows, which I have opened over here, you'll want to open up a new Explorer window. You'll go to your primary hard drive here. Then you'll go to users, then your username, app data, which might be hidden. So if you have hidden folders hidden, you'll want to show them. Then local, then temp. And the same thing happens here. I'm sorting by date modified. And because I don't have Lightroom or Photoshop opened right now, there are no TIFF files. But if I did have that workflow going where I sent an image from Lightroom Desktop to Photoshop, it would appear here just like on Mac. So just wanted to show you that location over there. I will also paste the terminal command for Mac and this path for Windows in the description below. And so let me go ahead and illustrate to you that how this TIFF file will go away. So just like before, I'm just going to go back to Photoshop here. Let's go ahead, we'll add a curve, one of my beloved S curves. And then I'm also going to create a stamped layer here. And I'm just going to apply an orphaned effect by going to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Let's go ahead and just apply this amount. Let's change the blending mode to soft light. And let's drop that opacity to about 25%. All right. So this will allow me to do two things. I'm going to be able to illustrate to you, if we go to Finder here, that when I save and close, this will go away. Also, if I just quit and didn't save, this file would go away as well. Also, one of the improvements with the Photoshop Lightroom interoperability that we released earlier this month is the ability to send multiple photos at once, which you couldn't do before. Now, when you do that, let's say you send 5 photos from Lightroom to Photoshop, maybe you want to composite them or focus stack them. Each of those images will have a TIFF file created. So that's why it's also really important to every now and then monitor the temp folder, because those, like I said, those TIFF files are pretty big in file size. And so it's just an easy way to kind of get rid of unnecessary space being used on your drive. So again, here, there's the TIFF file. I'm going to go ahead here. I'm just going to go to file close, which will bring up the save dialog here. I'm going to click on save. Let's bring up the Finder really quickly, and you'll see two things. First, the image goes into Lightroom. And second, once that's done, once this import is complete, you see that that TIFF file is gone because it was imported into Lightroom and the workflow process knows to remove that image so it's not orphaned in the temp folder. And the last thing that I want to talk to you about is layer preservation. So let me unstack this over here. Let's say for whatever reason, here is that TIFF file that we created. Let's say you want to go back and, I don't know, you don't want the orphaned effect, but you wanted the tone curve that we applied. So if I right-click right now and I go to Edit in Photoshop and select Edit in Photoshop again, you'll see over here there are our layers, right? Now, let me close out of here. I'm not even going to do anything. And this time, I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to open up the Edit panel and I'm just going to drop the exposure and maybe add some contrast. I don't know, just I'm making edits basically is what I want to show you. Now watch what happens. Let's say I go to grid here, I right click, I go to edit in Photoshop, and I send it back to Photoshop over here. Notice how the layers are gone. That's because a new file was baked. If you make edits in Lightroom to a TIFF file, those layers will be gone. So let's just say it's really important that you want to access those layers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to close out of here. I'm going to go to the edit stack here, and I'm just going to reset the edits here. So basically, we're bringing this image back to its original state when it was imported from Photoshop and Lightroom. If I right click now and I go to edit in Photoshop, you'll see that there are our layers over here. Maybe this orphaned effect is not doing it for you, so we can delete that layer and then save it, and then it will re-import into Lightroom. And I think that's one of those things that trips a lot of people up, is they want access to their layers, but they made edits to the photo. And then when they send it back to Photoshop, they don't see those layers. So remember, all you need to do, if it was a TIFF file that had layers from Photoshop, all you need to do is reset the edits there and then open it back up, and you should see those layers intact. And then you can resave the image and then make your edits afterwards. And again, this is just a small little kind of slice of everything that you can do with Lightroom and with Photoshop. And Lightroom, it's just such a powerful ecosystem of apps. And if it's something that you're like, you're watching this and you're like, you know what, I want to learn even more about Lightroom Desktop, Lightroom Mobile, and Lightroom Web, then I invite you to check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'm so proud of this course. It's got over, I think, 11 hours of easy-paced lessons. It'll teach you everything you need to know about the Lightroom Cloud ecosystem, including how to work with Photoshop as part of your editing workflow. I'll go ahead and leave a link to that in the description below. Definitely check it out if you are interested. Now, I have these two playlists here. These are filled with tons of Lightroom and Photoshop and photography tutorials and videos. So if you got some time and you want to see the work that I've been sharing throughout the years, these are the two playlists you'll want to check out. As always, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is greatly appreciated. It does help. Again, to the 40,000 of you who've already subscribed, thank you. If you've not subscribed, click the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone. I will see you in 2025.